Hello everyone, myself Saurabh Maheshwari and I welcome you all to the ongoing lecture series on C programming. In the previous video, we saw a program on pointer arithmetic on integers. In this video, we will see how to perform the pointer arithmetic related to characters and how characters can be accessed with the help of pointers and how to manipulate the values of characters with the help of pointer variables. Okay, so from the statement first, statement at line number 4, a variable of integer type is created, which is whose name is A, and suppose it is stored at a memory location 1000, and the value of this particular integer is 65. Okay, in the next statement at line number 5, a character variable is created. Let us suppose the name of the character is CH and the value of this character is character A, and suppose the memory address is 2000. Okay, now similarly to the previous program we saw for integers, we are now taking three character pointers. Okay, so these are instead of integer pointer as per previous video, this is now character pointers. So three character pointers are there, so they are meant to store addresses of the character variables. The name is P, Q and R. Okay, and let us suppose they are stored at three random locations, that is 3000, 4000 and 5000. Okay, so these are the three memory locations of the pointer variables. Okay, so what does these pointer variables will store? These will store the addresses of character variables. Okay, so at the statement number 7, you can see that P has been assigned, pointer P has been assigned with address of a variable A. Okay, so you can see here that it might look confusing to you that A is an integer variable, okay, and its address you are assigning to variable which is character pointer. Okay, so this should not make a difference because the P has a capacity to hold an address. Okay, P has a capacity to hold an address, and this can be an address of either character or character convertible value. Okay, it can be an address. So integers are character convertible till they are in the range of 0 to 255. So integers in the range of 0 to 255 are character convertible. Okay, because they have their respective character, 8-bit character. Okay, so 8-bit character is available for every number between 0 to 255. Okay, so the address of A would be stored here. Address of A would be stored in P. From the next statement, address of CH, which is 2000, would be stored in Q. Okay, and here R equals to Q. R is the pointer variable of character type and it is taking the value of Q. Okay, so the value of Q is 2000, so that will be copied to this particular variable also. So by this way, all the three pointer variables have been assigned some memory addresses. P has memory address of, P is a character pointer, but it has a memory address of the integer variable. Okay, so this is the only difference that we have seen here, and I have shown this example to let you know that the integer addresses can also be assigned to the character type pointer. Okay, so this first printf at line number 10 is going for pointer P, pointer Q and pointer R. That is, value at pointer P is simply value at address in P. Okay, value at address in P. So this value at address in P, that is 65. Okay, so address in P is 1000
and value at 1000 is simply 65. So this 65 will be printed in the form of percent C. 65 will be printed in the form of percent C. So it would be printed in the form of capital A, that is A in uppercase, because 65 is ASCII value. 65 is ASCII value of character A. Fine. I have written in single quotes because this is a character. Okay, and you can see it is printed on the screen in the bottom of the output. Okay, so you can also see pointer Q and pointer R are also printed. So the value at address in address in Q is 2000 and the value at 2000 is small a. So this small a is printed as a value of pointer Q. And since R has the same memory address as Q, so the same value will be printed for pointer R. So these three values are printed by this and these three pointer statements, and with the help of percent C format specifier. Okay. Now we have these four different pointer arithmetic statements. Okay. Now we will see each one of them one by one, and we will see how these pointer arithmetic will make a difference in the values of the characters. Okay. Now taking this A, we have pointer P plus plus, and pointer P is inside the parenthesis. Okay. So first the parenthesis will be resolved. So pointer P is value at address in P. Address in P is 1000 and value at address in P is 65. So 65 will be plus plus. So 65 will be plus plus, so it would become 66. So this 65 will become 66. Okay. So this can be seen with the help of this particular statement. So if pointer P, pointer Q and pointer R, they are printed. So you can see pointer Q and pointer R are not changed. They have the same value as it was in previous statement. But this A is incremented to B because this was the ASCII value 65 and it is incremented to 66. And if it is printed in percent C format, so it would print character B. Okay. Now we will resolve the statement number B. Statement number B simply says pointer R equals to plus plus pointer Q. As we know that the pointer symbol has the higher priority than an increment operator, pre-increment operator. So value at this would be handled as this. Okay, this would be handled like this. So pointer Q is value at address in Q, which is character A. Okay. And this character A would be incremented, so it would become character B. And then this character B would be supplied to the value at address in R. So address in R is nothing but 2000. Okay, so 2000, that the value of 2000 would become this A, this B instead of A. Okay, so here you can see that printing pointer P, pointer Q and pointer R would print B because it has not been changed, and this A is changed to B, and this same A is also changed to B because the change in the memory location 2000. Okay, so a change was there, this 1000, so this is pointing to this, this 2000, so this is pointing to this, and this is also 2000, so this is pointing to this. So these are the resolution for the statement B. Now we will see statement number C, which is pointer R equals to pointer P plus plus. Okay. Now you can see that we have to first resolve the pointer P. The pointer P is 66. Okay. The value at address in P. So address in P is 1000 and the value at 1000 is 66. Now 66 would be resolved. Then first is this. Second would be assignment, and third would be the post increment, because in post increment, assignment takes place first and then it is the post increment happens. Okay, so this 66 would be transferred at pointer R. So this particular value, because it is a character pointer, okay, so a character pointer, and the variable, the place that is going to stored is to be storing a character. So this 66 will go to pointer R, and it would become capital B over here. Okay, so this small b would change into capital B. Okay, why it is capital B? Because this pointer P, which is 66, okay, this will go to pointer R, and since pointer R is having at the character type byte, okay, so that 66 will be converted into corresponding character, and that is capital B. Okay, and what will happen then this C, this is plus plus, will take place. So this 66 will become 67. So this 66 will become 67. Okay.
66 is incremented by 1, so it becomes 67. So the value at address 1000 becomes 67. So when after executing statement number C, this pointer P, pointer Q, and pointer R runs. So the pointer P, since it is printed in percent C and it is 67, so this is the ASCII value of 67. So that is C is printed, okay, and the value at address 2000 is B, and it is pointed by Q and also by R. So these BB is printed from Q and R. This is an important thing to note here, that we change the value of pointer P with the help of increment operator, and we change the value of pointer R with the help of assignment here. Okay, so now we will do for the next statement, which is pointer R equals to pointer Q plus plus. Okay, so now we will resolve the priority, as the priority of pointer variable is higher than the post increment operator. So first this would be resolved, that pointer Q will be assigned to pointer R. Okay, so now what is the value of pointer Q? Pointer Q has value as B. Okay, now this B would be assigned to pointer Q is transferred to pointer R. So the value of pointer Q is B. Okay, character capital B, that is this particular character, it will shift it to the value at address in R. So that is B already. So this would only transfer the same value B to B, and then it would do, we will resolve Q plus plus. Now this Q plus plus would shift the Q to the next memory location. Okay, suppose the value of Q is this 4000. Okay, so it would shift it to the next memory location, that would be 4001, because it is a character pointer. So that would be 4000. Q stores the address to be 2000, so it would increment it as 2001. So that would be the next memory address. But in this case, when we print pointer P, pointer Q, and pointer R, you can see that pointer R is printing B, because it is now pointing to this, but this 2000 is now changed as 2001. Okay, now this 2000 is changed into 2001. So this pointer is changed. Okay, this pointer is replaced, and this 2001 should be a new memory location. Okay, new memory location, and there could be a garbage, so that garbage should be printed. Okay, now one option is this. Okay, but here you can see that pointer P is printing 67 in character, so that is C it is printing, and it is the pointer Q is also printing C. it means that the next address here, while allocating the addresses by the compiler, actually we have taken these addresses as imaginary addresses, but what compiler has done, suppose compiler has taken 2000 address for the character variable ch, so it has used 2001 variable, 2002, these two locations for variable a. Okay, these two bytes for variable a, that is integer, and this is character. So when this 2000 is incremented to 2001, it moves to this variable a, pointing to this 2001 location, and which is of this variable a. So the same value of variable a or the same value at address 1000 is printed over here. So this is how this Q++ is resolved. This Q++ makes increment in the value of Q. Okay, in the value of Q. Okay, and value of Q is the address. So address moves to next contiguous memory location. Next contiguous memory location. Okay, so this is how pointers arithmetic is performed on characters. We will see how to perform the pointers access on the integer arrays and string arrays in the next video. Till then, thank you.